हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर नंद कुमार राव बावले फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग अंबाजोगाई इज गोइंग टू डील विथ अप्लाइड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स 1. दिस इज आवर 20th लेक्चर ऑन अप्लाइड थर्मोडायनेमिक्स 1. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कार्नोट साइकिल. सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट Brayton cycle. So yesterday we have discussed about gas power cycle, and in that one Carnot cycle is discussed. So now in today's lecture we'll be discussing about the Brayton cycle and Stirling cycle. So coming to the Brayton cycle consists of four processes, process 1 to 2. So this process 1 to 2 is nothing but isentropic compression process. So air is compressed or gas is compressed isentropically, and then process 2 to 3 is a constant pressure process during which the volume increases at constant pressure. So due to increase in the volume, the temperature of system decreases, and due to decrease in the temperature of at constant pressure volume increases, and the affinity of system is to absorb the heat energy from surrounding. So heat is entering during process 2 to 3, where the pressure remains constant and volume increases, whereas the process 3 to 4 is known as isentropic expansion process, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. So these two processes are isentropic process, where PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. So this is P is equal to constant process. 2 to 3 is constant pressure process, and after that point 4, after the expansion, again the system is compressed at constant pressure. So at constant pressure volume is reduced, and this is known as a constant pressure process. Same process, same cycle is represented on TS diagram. So the process 1 to 2 is isentropic process, during which no heat transfer, so heat transfer is zero, that is the entropy remains constant. And during process 2 to 3 it is a constant pressure process, during which the volume increases but the pressure remains constant. So heat energy enters into the system from surrounding to system. This is Q in. And the process 3 to 4 is nothing but expansion process, which we call as isentropic expansion. PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, or heat transfer dQ is equal to zero, or entropy remains constant. And after point 4 to 1, this is constant pressure compression process, during which heat is rejected to the surrounding. So it is compression process. Generally in the compression process heat is produced, and that heat is rejected to the surrounding. So these are the four processes in Brayton cycle. So let us see process 1 to 2. This process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process, or the working substance may be a gas is isentropically compressed. So isentropic compression process One to two is isentropic compression process, whereas two to three, as shown in this PV diagram, pressure remains constant. So this we call as a constant pressure process, or during which heat addition process. So we can call as a constant pressure heat एडिशन प्रोसेस. देन द प्रोसेस 3 to 4 ड्यूरिंग विच द एयर और ए गैस इज एक्सपेंडेड आइसेंट्रॉपिकली. सो द प्रोसेस 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion. Isentropic expansion process, whereas 4 to 1 again is a compression process. It's a constant pressure compression process. We can call this as it is a constant pressure volume reduction process. 4 to 1 heat rejection or constant pressure heat rejection, we can call constant pressure heat rejection process. Then if we want to find out heat supplied during the process 2 to 3, so heat supplied during process 2 to 3, that is nothing but QS equal to, so this process 2 to 3 is constant pressure process. So during constant pressure process, heat supplied or heat rejected is given by mcp delta t, assuming that mass of working substance is 1 kg unit mass. So here we find out this as cp, temperature change in the temperature, t3 minus of t2. So this gives us equation number 1. So heat supplied, heat transfer during process 2 to 3 is given by mcp delta t. Delta t is change in temperature from t2 to t3. So cp is specific heat at constant pressure in kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. So now heat rejected, during the process 4 to 1. Is given as QR is equal to, again we use mcp delta t, m is equal to 1, mass of working substance is 1. So cp, change in the temperature during process 4 to 1 is T4, higher temperature T4 minus T1. So we call this as equation number 2. Therefore the work done during the cycle is given by heat supplied QS minus heat rejected. So this can be given as T3 minus T2 minus of CP T4 minus T1, equation 1 minus equation 2. So this can be written as CP is taken common, CP in bracket T3 minus T2 minus of T4 minus T1. So we call this as work done per kg of working substance. This is heat rejected per kg of working substance. This is heat supplied. QS is heat supplied. per kg of working substance, QR is heat rejected per kg of working substance, WD is work done per kg of working substance. We call this as equation number 3, say. Now, air standard efficiency of a Brayton cycle is given as efficiency is equal to work done divided by heat supplied work done is equal to QS minus QR whole divided by QS. So we call this as equation number 4. So we know work done is equal to CP in bracket T3 minus T2 minus of T4 minus of T1, closing this bracket. Heat supplied is given by CP T3 minus T2. So CP gets cancelled. Dividing this first term with first term, we get 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2. So this again can be written as 1 minus, in the denominator we take T1 as a common. By taking T1 as common, we can write here from T4 and T1 we have taken common as T1. So T4 divided by T1 minus 1 divided by denominator we take T2 as a common factor. So T2, T3 divided by T2 minus 1. So we write this as equation number 5. Now coming to the PVT relations. Applying PVT relations to the isentropic process 1, 2 and 3, 4. Applying the isentropic process applying the isentropic equation for the processes 1, 2 and 3, 4 process 1, 2 and 3, 4. We write relation between temperature and pressure as T2 divided by T1 is equal to P2 divided by P1 whole divided by to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma, and T3 divided by T4 is equal to P3 divided by P4 to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So we can write this as P3 by P4 as P2 divided by P1 to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So looking at this PV diagram, pressure at 1 is equal to pressure at 4. P1 is equal to P4, and pressure at 0.2 is equal to pressure at 0.3. So P2 is equal to P3. That means in place of P3 we have substituted P2, in place of P4 we have substituted P1. So here, looking at these two equations, say equation number 6 and 7, so we call this as 6 and this we call as 7. So right hand side of equation 6 and 7 is same, therefore left hand side will be equal. So T2 divided by T1 is equal to T3 divided by T4. So we can write this as equation number 8. Substituting this value of equation number, or equation, we can rearrange this as T4 we take on left hand side, because in previous equation T4 divided by T1 we want here. So for this, T4 is taken on left hand side, so this equation can be written as T4 divided by T1, which is equal to T3 divided by T2. So we write this as equation number 8. So from equation 8, substituting this value of T4 divided by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. In the equation number 5, T4 divided by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. So this bracket in numerator becomes equal to the bracket in denominator. Therefore, these two bracket values will be same. That can be cancelled. And what is going to remain? Efficiency is equal to 1 minus T1 divided by T2. So substituting the values of, or value from equation 8 in equation 5, we get the efficiency is equal to 1 minus T1 into T4 divided by T1 minus of 1 whole divided by T2, T3 divided by T2 minus 1. So T4 divided by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. So this bracket in numerator gets cancelled with bracket in denominator. So we can write as efficiency is equal to 1 minus T1 divided by T2. So this is the efficiency of Brayton cycle, where T1 is the temperature at point 1 and T2 is the temperature at point 2. So this again can be written as efficiency of Brayton cycle is obtained as 1 minus T1 divided by T2 now. So from this equation number say 9, we can write efficiency of Brayton cycle in terms of temperature. So this again can be written as 1 minus P1 by P2 to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So this P1 divided by P2 can again be written as T1 by T2 is equal to P1 by P2 to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma, applying this isentropic law to the process 1 to 2. The relation between temperature and pressure can be given by this equation, replacing T1 by T2 by P1 by P2. Again, we can change this. 1 divided by P2 divided by P1 to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So this P1 which is in the numerator is brought into the denominator of denominator, and we can write as 1 minus 1 divided by Rp to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So efficiency is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by Rp to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma, where Rp is equal to pressure ratio. We can call this as a pressure ratio. Which is given by P2 divided by P1. So this is the efficiency of Brayton cycle. First, efficiency in terms of temperature. Second, efficiency in terms of pressure ratio. We can find out the efficiency of Brayton cycle. Now coming to this next cycle, Stirling cycle. So Stirling cycle is also one of the gas power cycle. So this consists of again four processes. First process is 1 to 2 isothermal process, which follows the law PV raised to PV is equal to constant, or temperature is equal to constant. So this process 1 to 2, which is shown on PV diagram by this curve on PV diagram, is shown by straight horizontal line on TS diagram. So process 1 to 2, where entropy decreases, that means when entropy decreases, the heat energy is transferred from system to surrounding, Q out, it is rejected. So here this is isothermal compression process. During compression process, in order to maintain temperature constant, heat has to be rejected, QR. Then the system follows this constant volume process. So in this constant volume process, the pressure is increased at constant volume, and that constant volume process is shown by a vertical line on PV diagram, whereas constant volume process is shown on TS diagram by a curve. So again, after this, the working substance is expanded isothermally. Again, it follows law PV is equal to constant, or temperature is equal to constant. So when there is expansion process, volume is increasing and pressure is decreasing, definitely the temperature of system decreases and the heat from surrounding enters into the system. Heat is supplied during process 3 to 4. So this process 3 to 4 is isothermal process, which is shown on TS diagram here. So constant temperature process or isothermal process, PV is equal to constant, or T temperature, T is equal to constant, during which heat is supplied to the system. So these processes we will write here in detail. Process 1 to 2 is nothing but isothermal compression process. Isothermal compression process, process 1 to 2, which follows the law PV is equal to constant, or temperature is equal to constant. Then process 2 to 3 is heat addition at constant volume. So heat addition, pressure is increased by adding heat. So here also heat flows from surrounding to system. So heat addition heat addition at constant volume process. Then process 3 to 4, it is isothermal expansion, PV is equal to constant, or temperature T is equal to constant. process 3 to 4, isothermal expansion process. Expansion of working substance takes place. Then process 4 to 1 is constant volume heat rejection process. So heat rejection at constant volume. Now heat supplied is during process 3 to 4 and heat is rejected during process 1 to 2. So as earlier we have seen, during isothermal process heat is rejected and during isothermal process heat is supplied. Heat supplied and heat rejected. So heat supplied and heat rejected can be obtained during these two processes. So here heat supplied is given by QS, which is equal to heat is supplied during process 3 to 4. Isothermal process P3 log to the base E V4 divided by P3, or this can be written as PV is equal to RT. Using relation PV is equal to RT, we can write this as R T2 log of V4 divided by V3. So this is QS is equal to R T2 log to the base E bracket RC, where RC is compression ratio, where R suffix C is compression ratio. RC is equal to V1 divided by V2 or V4 divided by V3. So this is the volume V1 divided by V2 is compression ratio, or V4 divided by V3. Then this can be written as compression ratio as V4 means swept volume plus clearance volume divided by clearance volume. Swept volume means this stroke length, we call this as a swept volume, and this gap above the piston head, we call this as a clearance volume VC, and this distance we call as PS. V4 means V4 is equal to V1, and this is summation of VS plus VC is V4 or V1. V2 is equal to V3. V2 and V3 are same, that is nothing but clearance volume VC. Now heat rejected. Heat rejected QR Q suffix R during process 1 to 2 which is given by P1, V1 log to the base E, V1 divided by V2, because this process 1 to 2 is isothermal process and heat supplied or rejected during process is given by P1 V1 log to the base E V1 divided by V2, or it can be given as P2 V2 log V1 divided by V2. There are many more formulas, so out of that we select one which is convenient to us. So P1 V1 can be written as RT1 log of V1 divided by V2. This can be written as again RT1 log V1 by V2 is again RC, compression ratio. So work done. And during the cycle, is given by heat supplied minus heat rejected. So this heat supplied is RT2 log to the base E, compression ratio RC, minus of heat rejected is given by RT1 log to the base E, again compression ratio RC. So we can take here R log to the base E RC as a common factor, and in other bracket we will have T2 minus T1 as the remaining things. Now the efficiency of Stirling cycle is given by work done divided by heat supplied. Work done is given by R log to the base ERC, in another bracket T2 minus T1 whole divided by heat supplied is given by R log RT2 log to the base ERC. So RR gets cancelled, log to the base ERC, log to the base ERC gets cancelled. So the things which are left is 1 minus T1 divided by T2. So this is the efficiency of Stirling cycle, 1 minus T1 divided by T2 is the efficiency of Stirling cycle. So today we stop here with the gas power cycles. So in next lecture we will solve few numericals on this gas power cycle, and then we will conclude with this unit. Thank you.